I have a really cool item I'd like to show you today. It's an NCE Radio Cab 06. So let's go to the workbench right now and check it out. Now what I have to share with you today is an NCE Cab 06. It is a potentiometer cab and it is radio equipped and has that new LED screen. A lot of you have already seen that. So I ordered this from my good friends at Midwest Model Railroad and they sent it to me. In fact, if you go back, there'll be a video located up somewhere right around here and you can watch that video where they pack it and ship it and I open it and that kind of good stuff. So let's open this up and see what it is. We got our manual, our throttle, and our cord. That's pretty much what's in the box. The one item that did not come with my power cab is an updated program chip. Now that this version of the Cab 06 has been out for such a long time, they no longer ship with that updated program chip. In the manual, it says it comes with one. My Power Pro was not equipped with the updated chip, so I just contacted NCE and talked to Ed, and he shipped me one immediately. And I already have that installed. That is in a different video if you want to see it right there. Check it out. Setting up the Cab 06 is not that hard. It does require a unique cab address for it. In fact, it shows them right here. Setting up this cab, I just checked out my Excel spreadsheet and I have cab 33 is open. So I'm going to label this as cab 33. Slap it on the bottom. And there we go. Cab 33, this is ready to go on the layout. One of the issues people have with the NCE cabs is getting the battery cover off to install batteries in it. If you order it from someplace like Midwest Model Railroad, they actually give you a tool in the box to take the battery cover off. And I'll show you how this tool works. It requires a couple items from home, but you can use this tool to pop this cover off. And once you do it, it's like, why haven't I done this before? So let me show you how it's done. What you first need to do is take a pair of scissors, find your card, take the end, and cut a strip off less than a quarter inch wide. Cut a second strip off less than a quarter inch wide. Discard this. Now what you have are your two tools needed to pop this cover off. The next tool you'll need is called a chip lifter. I have a link down below so you can order one of these from Amazon. It is basically a mini crowbar. It's used for popping chips out of electronics, but this little crowbar foot is what you're after, and the angle. You can do this with a screwdriver, but this little angled end is what you're after. So let me show you what you do. Now what you do is you take the claw on the chip lifter and you slide it right into that notch area and you pull back on the tab like that. Hold it in place, take your little tool strip and pop it down in there just like that. Now we slide the controller over and it'll do the exact same thing on the other clip. Chip lifter in that little groove, pull it back, hold it, slide it in, and there you go. Take your two tabs, ready, and lift, and you're out. I'll do this one more time for you in wide angle so you can see what I've done. I'll take my chip lifter, find that little groove, pull the tab back, don't push in or down, just pull it back, slide in that slip of card, and then we repeat it on the other side. Chip lifter, pull back, slide in that card, and we have the two cards holding the tabs back. Take your tabs, push a little bit forward, and lift. And that's how easy it is to get the cover off the NCE cab. Now that we've done that, let's install some batteries. Now this NCE cab requires four AAA batteries, so we'll install those real quick, and it's pretty easy. Just like any other electronic toy, just push them in. And that is all it takes to put the batteries into this new cab. Now another useful item with the chip lifter is removing batteries. Same thing, take your hook. You can hook the back of the battery and lift out your batteries. Just like that. Pull towards the spring, or push towards the spring, I should say. So, very useful tool. If you don't have this, like I said, the link is down below. It's called a chip lifter. Just click on the link and it'll take you right to the Amazon page where you can order one of these. It also is great for pulling track nails and everything. Anything you'd want, a little mini crowbar, this is what you want. So let's set the batteries back up. Now we put the cover back on it and we are done. We're ready to play. Now to turn the unit on, it's really easy. You hit horn, comes up the address 33. It tells me what it is. I've already programmed it to 33. And to turn it off, it is simple. It's a shift and the horn, and it turns the unit off like that. Now I'll head back to the train room and I'll show you how I already programmed in address 33. Now that we are back out in the layout room with our brand new Cab06, we can check the address on it. It's really easy. We just plug it in and it tells us right here in the LED display, it's address 03. We need to change this so we don't compete with other throttles. As an example, this is throttle number 3. Address 3, I should say. This one is address 22. We do not want to compete. Just like a locomotive on your layout, each throttle or control device needs its own address. To change the address, and we're going to change this one to 33, it's very simple to do. You unplug it, hit the select button, plug it back in. We hit 33 for the address, enter. You can unplug it again, plug it back in. It is now set to address 33 as it flashes by. 33, and this throttle is ready for use. Another neat thing that they've done is they've added a whole bunch of information on the back to help you use it. The old cabs don't have this. You can actually make a sticker and stick it on your old cabs if you want to, but it tells you how to select your locos and all that kind of good stuff. So we'll go play with this on the layout. I'm really happy with my brand new Cab06 from NCE. If you'd like to see more videos on NCE products, check out that video and that video right there. And as always, stay frosty, my friends.